And from the river even to the ends of the earth.
The prophet Zechariah sees Jesus some 400 years before he comes. He sees him riding on a colt, the foal of an ass, which is a donkey. He is just and the king cometh having salvation. When you turn, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. To Luke chapter 19. Somebody shout glory. Starting at verse 29. This is where you find Jesus getting ready for that prophetic utterance by Zechariah here in this New Testament scripture. The triumphal entry into Jerusalem, where we celebrate with the waving of the palms, the branches from the palm tree. This is where they got this from. Verse 29, Luke 19, what it says.
And it came to pass, when he was come nigh to Bethpage and Bethany.
Bethpage and Bethany were situated closely together, a few miles from Jerusalem. Somebody shout glory. It was close, real close to Jerusalem. Somebody said it was so close, it was a stone throw.
At the mount called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples.
And what did he tell them?
Go ye into the village over against you.
Yes.
And the which at your entering,
ye shall find a colt tied, whereon yet never man sat. Loose him and bring him hither.
Now, what's really miraculous about the text is Jesus gives the disciples instructions to do without any questioning. He says, Lord have mercy. He comes to close to Bethany, in Bethany, town in Bethany, and he says, I want you to go into the village, disciples. Somebody shout glory. And I can just imagine that in my spirit that Peter was one of those. Somebody shout glory. And he tells them, say, there's a village over against you there. And when you get into the village, you're going to find there is a colt tied there. And this colt that was tied there, no man hath never sat upon him. It's all right for me to tell you, you're not colt stealing, because the master have given you instructions to loose him and to bring him hither. And if God and Jesus ever tell you to do something, there is nothing illegal about it. Somebody shout glory. If God tell you to do this, it's going to be all right. It means everybody is going to understand it. And he says, if any man asks you what you're doing and why you're doing this, I just want you to say to them, because the Lord have need of him. So if they're trying to stop you and try to stop you from bringing this colt unto me, just tell them, use my name. Say the Lord have need of him. And when you talk to them and say the Lord have need of them, I've already summoned them. If they come up against you, to let you know you ain't going to have any problem. I've already taken care of the business. That there is going to be no distraction, because my time is at hand, and you got to do what I said. The Bible said they that were sent, they did just as Jesus said. They went across the village, and they found even as he said unto them. And they said to the owners of the colt thereof, he said, why loose ye the colt? And they talked to the owner, and they said, the Lord have need of him. Somebody shout glory. And the Bible don't declare and say who the owners were, but there had to be some folk that had some type of recognition of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And when I read this text, I look how awesome God is, and how he stages the whole process of redemption. Somebody shout glory. And the reason I celebrate that God has kept us alive these many years, to celebrate every April when Palm Sunday comes, we recognize now the true meaning of this Sunday that leads up to next Sunday. Say yes, somebody. I just want to encourage you that sometime in our lives, there are going to be some folks that's going to elevate you and going to celebrate you, and they're going to turn around and going to bring you down. But that's all right. It's did it to Jesus. They're going to do it to you. You ain't got to die like Jesus did, but you're going to be met with some adversity, and it's all right. Don't get upset when folks lift you up one day, and the next day they're ready to stone you, put you down. The Bible said they bring the coat, Lord have mercy, to Jesus. They brought the coat to Jesus, and they cast their garments upon the coat, and they sat Jesus, Lord have mercy, thereon. And as I study the scripture, somebody saw glory and exegeting the text, they were saying that God chose a coat because this was a humble way. It was a peaceably entering into Jerusalem.
It wasn't a big horse, but it was a colt. Somebody shout glory. He came, Zechariah said, in a lowly. He was in a lowly state. Some of us find it difficult being in a lowly state. Somebody shout glory. You got to allow God to humble you. Jesus humbled himself even to the death of the cross. He came humbly, riding in Jerusalem on a colt. Said somebody, as he was coming down, Lazarus had been healed. Somebody shout glory. Lazarus had been raised. The multitude had come from everywhere because they came to celebrate the Passover. Somebody shout glory. So people already was coming from all over the world, from Rome and Greece, and there's Africa, Ethiopia, and the surrounding areas of that Mid-Eastern region. They were congregating into Jerusalem because it was a yearly festival of the Passover. And the Passover was celebrated by the Jews because God gave them an exodus out of Egypt through and by the last plague. When I see the blood, I will pass over. And God told them to remember this day, to make it a memorial for the rest of their lives. And 2,000 some odd years later, we are still celebrating the feast of the Passover, or the feast of the unleavened bread. Say yes, somebody. And here comes Jesus into Jerusalem. It just seemed to happen at the time of Passover,
the biggest time of the year. I want everybody to know that I'm king.
Yes.
No holds barred. Lazarus just been miraculously raised from the dead. But it wasn't about Lazarus.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Come here, Apostle.
God have mercy. Yes. If you read in John chapter 12, you don't have to turn there right now, you would find out that the high priest, the scribe, was so upset of Lazarus' resurrection. It was getting so much attention that they said, we need to kill both of them. And we get upset and all bent out of shape when folk don't like us. Let me tell you something. When you do a work for God and for the name of Jesus, y'all better listen to me. I want you to know you're going to be hated. Y'all better hear me. So the saints in the third world countries, y'all better stay in America. In the third world countries are suffering. Churches are being bombed. Y'all don't hear me. Just because of this gospel, we live in the best nation that you can ever imagine. You ought to thank God for where we are. But I tell you, saints, prophetically, that persecution is about to come on this soil. Y'all better hear me today. And I'm not trying to scare you, but I'm trying to tell you that the end is drawing nigh. And God sent you all by here for me to tell you that this is a day of reckoning. And we need to open up our eyes and see and understand that all of this is not about us. Ain't about your clothes. Ain't about what you drive, where you live, what you got in your bank account. It's all about us knowing Jesus. And what's his name? His name is Jesus. Somebody shout glory. The Bible says, as they spread their clothes, they spread it in the way. As I'm coming in here, and when he was come nigh, at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude, the disciples began to rejoice and to praise God with a loud voice, all the mighty works that he had seen. I tell you today, the reason why we ought to lift the roof off this church is because we celebrate the death, burial, and the resurrection of a risen Savior. He's
went into Jerusalem, they were saying, blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in his highest. Y'all better shout up in here. God wants somebody that will declare his name. We don't talk about it enough. Some of us are ashamed to name the name of Jesus. Some of us are ashamed to tell folks you're saved, that you're sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized, bound in the water, in Jesus' name. The Bible says that the some of the Pharisees and the multitude said, Lord, unto him, Master, Lord, have mercy. Master, rebuke thy disciples. Say at somebody. And he answered and said unto them, I'll tell you that if these should hold their peace, he was saying, shut them up, shut them up. They're making all of this fuss over this entry into Jerusalem. He said, you ought to shut them up. Don't let them say nothing. But Jesus said, if you shut them up, the rocks would cry out. Say it, somebody. You can't shut this thing up. It wasn't done in no corner. Say it, somebody. John said, they took branches off of palm trees. They went forth to meet him. They cried, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is the King of Israel. The King of Israel. Somebody shout, Hosanna. Get up on your feet and say, Hosanna. Say, Hosanna. Hosanna. Blessed is the King of Israel. Jesus, when he found the young ass set thereon, as it is written, said, fear not, daughters of Zion. John 12 and 15 said, behold, behold, thy King. Somebody said, my King cometh. My King, my King, my King, my King, he cometh. I just want you to know that God, Jesus, is here right now. He came, but he was wrong.